The indoor courtyard at the Isabella Gardner Museum is a cozy, leafy retreat for humans, but for plants, it's a tough environment.
Luckily, they have a champion in Stan Kozak. For nearly 50 years, he's been the guardian of the gardener's garden.
It is truly one of Boston's treasures, a lush green jewel hidden inside an old stone castle, the interior courtyard at the Isabella Stewart Gardner Museum. But the dreamlike serenity is deceiving.
Another good cut.
It takes an immense amount of work to keep this garden green. On Tuesdays, when the museum is closed, a team of gardeners descends on the courtyard like medics at the scene of an accident. You see, of all the places to try to keep plants alive, few are as challenging as the Gardner Museum.
Unfortunately, the Gardner Courtyard ranks pretty close to the bottom. It's kind of like a death sentence to place them into the museum.
And that makes Stan Kozak a miracle man, head gardener at the Gardner for close to half a century.
Been here 48 years, and the plants and I have a relationship, I guess you would say. They tell me when they need to be pruned. They tell me when they need to be fertilized.
Flowers have but a brief moment in the spotlight here at the museum.
Average lifespan for a flowering plant in the museum is 7 to 10 days. So we have plenty of backups, and if you came at the beginning of the month and then the end of the month, you would think you're seeing the same plants, but they've been replaced at least 2 or 3 times.
Survivors are medevaced back to the museum's greenhouse in Hingham.
And the greenhouses are the hospital after the fact. We try to revive them.
Kozak has about 10,000 plants here, awaiting their star turn in the courtyard. None are more pampered and fussed over than the nasturtiums, perhaps the museum's most anticipated annual flower display. The nasturtiums require 9 to 10 months of daily attention before they are unveiled every spring.
It's a tradition dating back to Mrs. Gardner's days, and she was fond of the nasturtiums in the museum continuously, year after year. We want to carry on that tradition.
We will come back for the big reveal in a bit, but for now, it's back to the show.
Welcome to the Boston Flower and Garden Show. This is our 9th show here at the Seaport World Trade Center in Boston.
For winter-weary, color-deprived, scent-starved New Englanders, the Flower Show is a welcome tonic. Featuring rooms full of artful flower arrangements, over a dozen fully landscaped gardens, and a bumper crop of vendors, like North Spore mushrooms from Maine, for those who want to grow their own.
It's starting to hit the mainstream now. We like to think mushroom cultivation is kind of like where microbreweries were about 10 years ago.
Kevin Bassett says North Spore is putting the fun back in fungi. The company's self-starting, home-growing mushroom kits, though, do spawn raised eyebrows.
It's a little freaky. It's a little weird. We definitely get a lot of that, like, oh, that's weird. And it definitely is. It's definitely a weird thing. Maybe that's why we like it so much.
Then there is the soil additive that dare not speak its name, at least on a family program like Chronicle.
We got fish here. It's a probiotic for the plants.
Joe Blanchard and Tom Leonard harvest the raw material for their product at their tilapia fish farm in Rehoboth.
We say Mother Nature has been growing stuff in this for a million years. We just put it in the bottle so your fingers don't stink.
There is fine art here as well, if a little seedy.
Our first year when I was like, oh, we get to create our own seed packs. What do we want them to look like?
Ken Green of the Hudson Valley Seed Company turned to his artist friends for help. Now his colorful seed packs are collector's items.
And it just took off from there. We've commissioned over 200 works of art.
Ladies and gentlemen, do me a favor. Lean in here just a little bit. I want you to watch ordinary mud. The same snow, rock salt.
And what dirt. Convention would be complete without a miracle product?
No matter how much you wipe and you swipe and you tell people, wipe your feet. You always got a reason to gripe. You're gonna be famous. Come over here.
Master salesman Hal Yes is hawking the Miracle Garden mud mat.
1, 2, 3, no debris. Can we have a round of applause for our helper? We're gonna have fun all weekend long. Same mat, same mud, same bad jokes.
Oh, there you go. And the flower show has come and gone, but mark your calendars because it is an annual event.
And back to the gardener, you know, the courtyard, of course, is covered by a glass ceiling, but it just doesn't let enough light in to keep plants healthy. And also, the humidity obviously is controlled there, but that's for the priceless artworks. It's not necessarily for the flowers and the plants, so they don't do as well as the artwork does.
All right. Back at the Gardner Museum, the nasturtiums are ready for their close-up.
It is go time.